Hi, I'm Ron Pars from parpools.com, and today I want to talk to you about pink slime and white water mold. Pink slime and white water mold are probably two of the most misunderstood pool problems that are out there. And in this video, we want to tackle what they are not, and how to best treat them, and then going forward, prevent their happening. Pink slime and white water mold are naturally occurring problems. They come from garden hoses and your tap water. They are not caused by any particular chemical that you're adding into the pool, such as a biguanide, such as Bacrosil or Soft Swim. They are not caused by that, but they are naturally occurring. First of all, let's take a look at pink slime. Pink slime is sometimes known as pink algae. Pink slime is not algae. Pink slime is bacterial. It is animal and not vegetable. Like I said, it is naturally occurring. In fact, you'll not only find pink slime growing in swimming pools, but you'll also find it in your bathtub, in your sink, in your toilet, anywhere where there is moisture. If you've noticed over the years, you have to clean the bathtub and the toilet bowl a little bit more often, and it has this orangey look. That's not metals, that is pink slime. So we want to treat it. The other problem is white water mold. White water mold is a naturally occurring fungus. It's mold. Oftentimes, we will find both of these together, and the pink slime grows on top of the white water mold. Better yet, if you want to say that, is that both of these grow on top of a biofilm. And biofilm is just a simple bacterial film that is found on every pool surface, and when it gets attached, it just begins growing. Many years ago, there were people who truly believed that pink slime and white water mold were problems of biguanide pools, and that is so far from the truth. In fact, our very first pink slime and white water mold problem was discovered with one of our customers. And we'd been helping her battle this issue for a couple of weeks. And one day she called us up and said, "I found the source of our problem. You've got to come up to the house." So I went up there and managed to get one of the chemical reps to come up with me. And what we saw was that, and as our customer saw it, when she was adding fresh water into her pool, there was a literal glob of pink slime and white water mold going from her garden hose into the pool. So the problem is environmental. If you're going to be filling your pool with your garden hose, which more than likely you are, it's best to run the garden hose for a couple of minutes to hopefully flush out any excess bits. One thing to keep in mind is that water mold and pink slime typically grow in areas that you cannot reach. So they will grow in or behind lights, the insides of skimmers, the backs of a return fitting. If you take the eyeball off and look at the back, you'll find a little bit of pink sometimes growing in there. Underneath your skimmer basket. They may seem like high circulation areas, but in reality, they are poor circulation areas. You'll find that stuff growing in shady areas of the pool as well, such as around a return fitting or around a skimmer faceplate. Another thing to keep in mind with white water mold and pink slime is that they are not pathogenic. In other words, they're not harmful. They can't harm you. They just look awful. And so to prevent that and to prevent some other pool water problems, we want to treat them. Pink slime and white water mold also have an affinity for PVC piping. In other words, white water mold and pink slime like plastic piping. So your pool is all the plumbing is made with plastic pipe, using plastic pipe. So it is naturally going to grow there. If you're having a pink slime or white water mold problem within the pool itself, the odds are is that the filter system is completely contaminated, because it will grow throughout the filter system first before coming out into the main pool. When you're treating pink slime and whitewater mold, you have to remember that these problems are incredibly resistant to chlorine, bromine, peroxide, any kind of shock. If anything, they will absorb some of that material. So, in order to get rid of it, you have to brush the pool. And therefore, we talk a lot about brushing the pool and doing regular maintenance. When you are vacation-proofing the pool during the midsummer, consider taking the ladder out. Clean underneath all of those ladder treads, and you'll find pink slime or whitewater mold growing underneath there. When you begin to have a serious problem, you will notice that you start burning through a lot of chlorine or a lot of sanitizer, and that's normal because you're putting an excess bacterial strain on the swimming pool. One of the great ways that you can combat pink slime and whitewater mold, and we've had excellent success with this over the past 2 to 3 years, and that's using a product called Aquafinesse. Aquafinesse pool water tablets are designed specifically to remove the biofilm. So if the biofilm is on the pipe, is on the inside of the pipe, and then on top of it you have white water mold and pink slime, the Aquafinesse will help to slough off the entire biofilm. As it does that, it gets trapped in the filter and can then be backwashed and cleaned out. As you continue to use the Aquafinesse, it will continue to alleviate and minimize. And for most of our customers who continue using Aquafinesse, their pink slime and white water mold problems are essentially cured and taken care of. It's also a good idea to make sure that you are following all of the 5 keys to pool care. The 5 keys to pool care are good circulation, good filtration, proper cleaning, proper testing and water balance, and proper water chemistry. Follow all of those, brush the pool, maintain it, know what you are fighting, and you'll have excellent success. If you have any further questions, you can email us at techhelp@parpools.com. You can also visit our website at parpools.com/poolcare for more information. Thanks and enjoy your pool.